We have seen few HTML tags and their usage, like heading tag, paragraph tags, all the basic tags we have already studied, and we use them so far in their, you know, very simplest form. But most of the HTML tags can also have attributes which are contains additional information about the HTML elements. And attributes are always specified in the starting tag. It means that an attribute is used to define the characteristics of an HTML element and basically is placed, or you can say specified, inside the elements of the starting tag, or you can say the opening of tag. Okay, so let's take the paragraph tag. Okay, so this is the opening tag and this one is the closing tag. So if we want to define any HTML elements attribute, you have to put that attribute in the opening tag. Okay, so we will discuss it later on. Okay, so next is, all attributes are made up of two parts. Okay, first one is name and the second one is value. So first you put the name of the attribute and then you put the value of that attribute. The name is a property you want to set, and the value is what? And the value is what you want the value of the property to be set. Okay. So next is different attributes are there. So the first one is ID attribute. The ID attribute of an HTML tag can be used to uniquely identify any element with an HTML page. Okay, so basically it uniquely identify any element within the HTML page. Okay, next attribute is SRC attribute. So it specifies the URL web address for an image. Okay, so first I just want to give you a brief idea about all the attributes, and then we will run all the attributes one by one. Okay, so basically it gives just a web address for an particular image, and the file name of image source specified in the SRS attribute. Okay, the next one is alternate attribute. So this attribute basically, if image is not displayed, somehow if image is not displaced, then in that case text to be used. Okay, so it specifies an alternative text for an image when the image cannot be displayed. The value of the attribute can be read by user easily. Okay, so the next attribute is href attribute. It specifies the URL address for a link. It provides basically a link. You just click on it, this link, and you can easily go to that website or anything. That address, web address, is given in your in this attribute. Okay, and one more thing you have to remember is this link. Basically, this href attribute is written in this tag. In this opening tag of this A, href, like this. Okay, and the web address, and close this tag. Now the next one is width and height attribute. It specifies the height and width of table image or table cells. Next one is language attribute. It allowed to indicate the main language used in a document. Let's suppose you use the English language in the whole HTML document. So you have to specify in the HTML tag which language you are using. The next one is title attribute. This tag gives a suggested title for the element. The title attribute is added to the P element. Okay, the paragraph tag. It displays the extra information about an element as a tooltip. Okay, so let's execute all the attribute and run on the screen. So now start with this ID attribute. Okay, so as we already discussed that all the attribute will written in the opening tag of the HTML element. So this is a P paragraph tag, and in this paragraph tag, in the paragraph opening tag, I'm going to specify this ID attribute, and the ID is equal to HTML. This is the ID basically used to uniquely identify any element. within the HTML page. So this is HTML, and I have written this text, and I'm closing this paragraph text. Now the next same, I'm using this paragraph tag, and in this I'm specified this ID attribute, and this is the closing tag of this paragraph. Okay, so let's try to run this. Okay, so this launching Chrome. Now see what output is going to come. Okay, so this is what is HTML and this is what is CSS. So basically HTML and CSS, it defines these two uniquely. Okay, so next is, so next attributes are SRC and the alternate attribute. SRC basically used to provide the file name of image source specified in the SRC attribute. So this is I'm already give you idea about that. This SRC attribute are defined with img image tag. Okay, so this is img SRC is equal to give the name of file name of the image source. So this is image book.jpg, and in this I'm also combining this width and height attribute. The width is equal to 500 and the height of the image is 600. Okay, and the next one is alternate attribute. Basically alternate attribute is if the image is not displayed somehow, if the image is not displayed, then in that case alternate text should be used. Okay, so this alternate is equal to book with black cover page. Okay, so let's try to run this. Launch in Chrome. Let's save it and then execute it. Okay, now see. Okay, so this is the image we are talking about. We provide the name, file name of this source file, and if the image is not available, see, if the image is not available, then in that case book with black cover page. Okay, so the alternative text is pop up on the screen, right? So next is href and the style attribute. Let's uncomment these two attributes also. Okay, and save it. So the href and the style attribute, the href is used to provide the link address, web address. Okay, so this is the web address, www.gatelectures.com. so href attribute basically provide the link of this website, and it is enclosed in this opening tag of a tag. And the next one is style attribute. It specify the styling of any element like color, font and everything. So the style is equal to color is equal to red. This is a paragraph and we enclosed in this paragraph tag only. Okay, so let's try to execute them. This is launch in Chrome. See, okay, see, this is a paragraph, the style we are using, and this is a link. Due to href, we provide this link. This is a link. This is a link for the website www.gatelectures.com. Okay. Next is HTML comment. So basically, comment is a piece of code which is ignored by any web browser. Okay. So it is good practice to add comments into your HTML code, especially in complex documents. So this tag is used to insert the comments in the HTML source code. Comments help to understand the code and increase the code readability. Yes, content placed with, okay, so this is the syntax for the comment. Okay, so from the starting you have to put this exclamatory, and then you can add anything in this area and then close with this. Okay, and will be treated as comment and will be completely ignored by the browser. HTML supports multi-line comments as well. Okay. So next is HTML quotations. We use different quotations in HTML. Like we use this tag for the short line quotations. Okay. We use this tag for the abbreviations. Okay. Like if you want WHO. Okay, so WHO is the abbreviation. The full form is World Health Organization. Okay, next one is address. This tag is used for the contact informations. Contact informations like if you want to give any author or owner information, so you can put this address tag into your HTML document. And the next one is site. Site tag is basically used for the work title. And this site basically display in a italic form. Okay, so let's execute this all this tag together. So if you want to comment any line, or you want to uncomment any line in Notepad++, you have one shortcut key for that. Okay, so if this is a comment, okay, this is a comment. If you want to uncomment this line, so just select this line and Control Shift K. Now this line is uncomment. Okay, and again, if you want to comment this line, select this whole line and Control K. So simple. Okay, so next is quotations. So quotations, like if we use the Q tag, so whatever we write in this text and we between the opening tag and the closing tag of Q, so these will become under the quotations. Okay, so let's uncomment these lines, Control K, and execute first tag only. Okay, Control Save, and now run it. Launch in Chrome. So this is a quotation. Success comes to those who are too busy to looking for it. Okay, so this is the quotations. And now next is abbreviations. Uncomment this line, abbreviation tag, and Control Shift K. Now the abbreviation part is, in the abbreviation title is Hypertext Markup Language, and this is the abbreviation HTML. Okay, so let's see. S and run it. So this is HTML. Only abbreviation is shown on the screen. Okay. Next is address. So if you want to give contact information of your author or owner, you can give through the address tag. So let's uncomment this address tag to Control Shift K, save it and run it. So launch in Chrome. Now see, flat number, sector, city, pin code. You can, and after after every information, I put the break tag so that another piece of information will come from the another line. Okay, like flat number, sector, city, pin code. Okay, so next one is site. First uncomment this and then Control Shift K and then save it. So site is used for the title of a work, and it, the particular site like Forge Your Future will come in a italic font. Okay, so let's run it. Okay, launch in Chrome. See, Forge Your Future by APJ Abdul Kalam. Okay, so this is the keep this Forge Your Future text in the site tag. That's why the font is italic. Okay, so this is it.